Hello, my name is Arash Lavasan and I work in the engineering department at HUESKER Synthetic. In this video, I would like to introduce you to the topic of base reinforcements. Construction of base layers with high dead or traffic loads on soft soils is a challenging issue that can have serious consequences. There is a wide range of applications such as permanent roads and railways, storage areas, as well as temporary construction roads and working platforms that can be specified in this category. In these applications, the soil might be subjected to high static or dynamic pressures in short or long time periods. Depending on the loading conditions and the project purposes, attention can be paid to improving the durability of the construction with less maintenance efforts or to increase the serviceability of the project by restricting any aspect that slows down the construction process. Among many possibilities, such as constructing a thicker base layer, chemical soil treatment like using lime or cement, and soil replacement methods, reinforcing the soil with geosynthetic layers is in many cases the most efficient and ecological solution. In geosynthetic reinforced base systems, the reinforcement contributes to a better distribution of the stress towards the subsoil within a wider surface. In addition, the geogrid reinforcement provides a passive anchorage that not only improves the mechanical characteristics of the base layer, but also laterally confines the base layer. The passive anchorage, in conjunction with the tension membrane and higher confinement, results in a greater bearing capacity or a thinner layer of earth structure with the equivalent performance in terms of bearing capacity. On the other hand, the lateral restraint provided by the geogrid guarantees a better base compaction in accordance with less lateral spreading in the vicinity of the slopes. The interaction flexibility of woven reinforcement products allows the geogrid to adapt perfectly to the system geometry and to improve the interlocking between the aggregates and the reinforcement. In addition, the interaction flexibility increases the efficiency of the compaction in the reinforced soils. With the mechanical functions of the geosynthetic reinforcements, the stability of the system increases while the rotting depth reduces significantly under the identical loading condition. In addition to the improvement of the mechanical behavior of system due to reinforcing the base layer, the separation and filtration functions of the wovens or geocomposites avoid mixing the base aggregates with the fine subgrade. The separation function avoids the loss of good base layer material into the soft subsoil, where the filtration function prohibits the infiltration of the fine particles from subsoil into the base layer due to water flow. Apparently, preventing the infiltration of fine particles to the base layer and prohibiting the possibility of mixing the base aggregates with soft subgrade secures the perfect frictional contact between the aggregates and the base layer for a longer period of time. The type of raw materials used in geosynthetic reinforcements should be chosen in accordance with the desired tensile stiffness and strength, expected lifetime of the project, as well as the chemical properties of the soil and groundwater with respect to their acidic or alkaline characteristics. In order to design the base reinforcement for paved or unpaved systems, different empirical, analytical, and numerical approaches are available. These methods are mainly focused on achieving sufficient bearing capacity, tolerable rotting depth, and maximum durability of the system. I hope that you enjoyed this presentation. Should you be interested in further technical details and HUESKER solutions, please visit us at our website or feel free to contact us in person.